Hey, my little fox cubs! I hope you are all doing great today! Today, we've got a bit of a different format of video today. Today, I give you a little explanation and tour of the build, and that build is a combination lock, but it's a bit bigger than normal. So if you like this new format of video, tell me in the comments below and if I should continue it. So, yeah! Hope you have a great day, sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. See you at the end. Okay. Hello, my little fox gobs! I hope all of you are doing great today. Today, I'm actually going to explain what I actually built. You just saw me build. I'm actually going to explain it. Oh my god. Explanations this time? Pog? Explanations, Pog? Yeah, explanations, Pog. So, this is a combination lock. But it just has a little bit more finesse behind it. So, we're going to go over here. I'm going to explain what a combination lock does first. So, this is a basic one here. Basic 8-bit combination. It's not actually 8-bit, I just realized. But we'll work with it. It's 10-bit, or whatever. So, as you can see, the correct combination is hardwired into it. It's okayly easy to change, but it's not that easy. You have to go into redstone and look at crap. Ugh, disgusting. So, I built this. So, what you do, so you'd normally not see that. You wouldn't see the correct combination right up above, but we're going to work with what we did. Let's say we got it wrong. As you can see, the combination I am now putting in is wrong. Is completely wrong, and we go and hit the button and look at the redstone lamp. Nope, it was wrong. So you have to change it so it's correct. So just look how, so I'm just looking up here, kind of cheaty, but okay, that's correct. Hit the button again. Pretty loud, but it does work, as you saw just said. It does function. Okay, so what's all that stuff? So, back here, I've just got a little button that resets it. I can just reset it right here. There you see, just reset. That's the reset. So, back here is what is the selected code. This moves that code into the actual lock. So, we're going to go back and actually look at what selects these codes. Back here, we've got an input panel back here, and then this. This is what stores the 8 available quick load codes that you can put in. How I select these is through a item frame. So I've selected that one there, that code. We go over here. We've got a different setup. We hit reset on this button. It is put into the machine as the new lock. So this will now not function. So the previous code will now not work. Rain, go away! Okay. So that explains that. We've got 8 of the buggers. But we're going to select one so we can edit it. So that one there is this. What the? Wait, no. Okay. I thought it was like it was broken, but I've got to look down there to see if it's fixed. But it's to correct now. So this is how we set up a code. We set it up. Oh, the button's down there, by the way. I haven't moved it. It's down there, but we're going to use it later. So, let's say we want to put in a new code. Let's set that as our code. No, let's do 3 there. 1110010. Let's set that as our code. Pop down here and click that button. Now, can you see what's going on here? Extended, extended, extended. Retracted, retracted. Extended, extended. Extended, retracted, retracted. Now, we go around the front here. Bang! It is flipped. It is a little flipped. But that's a I'm not fixing that. But look. That is still the loaded code. But when I... You're supposed to reset the system like this. What loads that one in? Now, we can put that code that we just inputted into the system in. Boom, boom, boom. Hit this button. And boom. It's away. It's gone. It is now open. Get it wrong in any way. Let's reset the system just so you guys can see. Without my other one resetting. Get it wrong. Nothing happens. So it does work as a combination lock. In the next video, we're actually going to be making a proper control room for this thing and not just in the bowels of the redstone type control room, because you can kind of see everything. So let's get on to, like, actually how this works and not actually how to use it. Editor Ziggy jumping in just for a quick little thing. This next part takes a long time. I'm sorry. This takes a long time to explain. It's probably me, but hey. Let's do it. So, how does this machine work? Okay. Let's start with saving to the RAM. Let's see. I'm going to refer to this as RAM now. So, what actually happens is these, all the pistons right now that are in our little system, are being quasi-connectivity powered. But they don't realize it yet. We've got to send an update to them. That's what this button does. This button extends all the pistons on the selected, like, row. This is the first, this is the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, whatever. And this is the first row here. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. You get the deal. Now, if I send it again, we send this little signal to it. Oh, God. I fell. Send a signal. You see all of them extend and then they retract. Then the ones that weren't selected retract. That is it updated. You see, this one's not extended. These two aren't extended, but these two, those two, and these three are. So, this thingy over here. This, as I'll show you just now, gonna pop some ling, oh god, okay. So this little thing, you flick it, it moves on to the next one, and it cancels out that one. It cancels it out. So you see, you move it along, it cancels it out. That's just brought around here to, that's that. See, oh, wrong one. Wrong one. That is just brought from that control room around, using comparators, all the way around to here. What you just saw is just here. This is the RAM section. And you see, this is the RAM. Well, I'm going to refer it to RAM at the moment. And all the outputs come through this side. What I'm going to refer to as a bus right now. I'm going to refer to it as a bus as it transports the signal from the RAM to this bus here. We're using computer terms. Be quiet. Now, there's two of them. See, there's only four lines here. But there are eight outputs. There are four on each side that power the each individual pieces, individual lines. So, how I select these is by just pushing up and down these. So, if I move on to another one, if I move to another line adjacent, see what it did? It pushed this one up and pushed this one down, and now this is the one we're writing to. We're writing to and reading from. Now we can write to that one and override the already selected code. What is currently 1 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 1. Now it's flipped over here. It's flipped over here, as you can see. It's flipped for us. So we check in our new code. Let's say we're gonna hit like 0 1 1 0 0. Down there, we're gonna do down. It's different. Now we click the button down here. Down here. And that just overrid the code. And now as you can see, it is now the new code for that line. It is now saved in this line by all these extended pistons. Oh, it's only these ones that save that specific code. Each of these different each of these rows of prongs save different codes. Wow, I like extending the third one. First one. Wow, okay. Apparently I like extending the first one. Apparently I like it. Okay. The funny thing. Okay. That's that, I think, explained. I don't know if I've explained it very well. But, I might have explained it. Like, this sends the signals to the selector, so you can select each individual one. Like, if I flip this little thingy here, flipped again, bonk. Wait for it. You'll see it moves to the next one. Okay, let's follow down the bus to this section. As you can see, these aren't connected. They're being held back by this system up here, what is connected to the reset system. That's the current selected code. Kind of different. When we hit this button, it does a bunch of things. It resets this to zero, resets this to complete zero. What would normally turn off and unlock the door, that's what this circuit's for here. So it keeps it from unlocking. Okay. Then they're retracted and set to zero. All these are set to zero. Then these are extended. What powers individual ones. We're going to watch it right now. We're going to watch it all happen. Reset. Powers. There we go. So it resets this down here. Then powers these, extending the pistons that are the right ones. Now you wouldn't normally see this. And all the while, it's keeping this red line here powered throughout the entire process. Now, when I flip switches around, and when I flip switches, I'm doing nothing to the thing back there. I'm doing absolutely nothing. And I won't do anything until I hit this button. What actually resets the system again. So, and then this, reset system and make sure that's all set properly. Then, these are pushed down. After it's reset, these are pushed down. What extend or retract the ones in front here. So this one would have been extended by this. No, it wouldn't have. This one would have been extended. This one would have been retracted. But it's still wrong. It won't be right until I get the correct code in. So if I put the correct code in right now, what is that? Hit the button. It takes a bit of the process, but it does actually get it right. I hope I explained that well, my Fox Pups. I hope I explained it well. I don't know if I really did, but this is confusing. This is very complicated. Not that complicated. It's not like a complicated as a computer, but still, it's pretty big. Pretty sizable for a normal computer, for a normal thing. Now, you can size it all the way down, and if you don't want this quick select bit, the quick selection, what's literally all of this allows me to quickly change the code by just flipping through, and that's it. That's all I've got to do. Because it will now, because even though it's not updated here, if I hit the button, as I said, it resets itself. So now it's set. And that's kind of the reason why I set it like that. That it resets itself. Every time you do that. But eventually I want to have it so there's a button in the control room that just does this. Okay. In the next video, we'll be building the actual control room. The actual control room behind all this. We're making an actual control room, what I've kind of laid out here. We're going to be making an actual control room. It'll be probably around this location. with the input here. So this line here. Oh no, I'll explain it later. I'll explain it in the video. Hope you guys enjoyed this one and the time lapse that went along with it. Bit of a different video, guys, but hope you enjoyed. See ya in the next one where we can build the control room. See ya. Bye.